Good morning and welcome to the third annual Geo4Dev Symposium and Workshop. My name is Ron Goldblatt and I'm the Chief Scientist of New Light Technologies. First of all, I want to thank you all for joining us today, and I'm excited to see Geo4Dev evolving into an initiative with a relatively ambitious objective, bringing timely geospatial data to developing countries and equipping governments, policy and decision makers, NGOs, academia, the public sector, and importantly, the people, with the tools and knowledge that are necessary to translate geospatial data into meaningful information that could actually help improve people's well-being. Our world is rapidly changing in almost every dimension. In 2007, for the first time in history, the global urban population exceeded the global rural population, and many countries, especially in the developing world, are continuing to rapidly urbanize. It is projected that by 2050, nearly 70% of the world's population will live in urban areas. Obviously, urbanization has many positive implications. It helps grow economies, enhances opportunities for education, improves accessibility to public services, and in general, provides people with better living conditions. But this does not come without immense challenges. Rapid urbanization is causing damage to ecosystems, increased emission of gases, increased demand for public services, pressure on public infrastructure, and an increased gap between rich and poor. Only half of the world's urban population has convenient access to public transportation, and less than half lives within 400 meters walking distance to open public spaces. Urban areas are also the most vulnerable to the recent COVID-19 pandemic, with nearly 90% of all COVID cases reported in urban areas. With rapid urbanization outpacing investments in infrastructure development, housing, and basic services, the share of the population living in slums is now rising. The UN estimates that in 2018, the share of the urban population living in slums rose to 24%, primarily in Northern Africa, Western Asia, and Sub-Saharan Africa. Poverty and extreme poverty are also on the rise. In 2018, almost 8% of the world's workers and their families lived below the poverty line, and COVID-19 may push between 88 and 115 million people into extreme poverty. Natural disasters are another challenge many countries are facing. Since the 1940s, there has been an increase in the frequency and severity of global natural disasters. Extreme weather and floods account for the majority of global natural disasters, which kill every year close to 60,000 people. Low-income countries are especially vulnerable to the impacts of natural disasters. Yet accurate data on the number of poor people, their living conditions, and vulnerability are scarcely existent, especially in developing countries. Census counts comprise the primary source of this type of data, but these are published infrequently, varying in resolution and precision, due in part to limited available resources for data collection. The gap between developing and developed countries in the availability of data is attributed, at least to some extent, to technology and innovation gaps for data collection. Innovative sources of data facilitate the development of new approaches for demographic modeling and measurement of wealth, especially in the developed world, with fewer sources of big data existing for developing countries. For example, only about 35% of the population in developing countries has access to the internet, compared to nearly 80% in advanced economies. Food security is another challenge many developing countries face. Shocks related to climate change, conflicts, and infectious diseases are hurting food production, disrupting supply chains, and limiting accessibility to affordable food. According to the Food and Agriculture Organization, the FAO, nearly 690 million people, or close to 9% of the global population, experience hunger, up by nearly 60 million in 5 years. In light of these challenges, the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development aims to end poverty and to set the world, quote, on a path of peace, prosperity, and opportunity for all on a healthy planet, end quote. The agenda recognizes the importance of space technology-based data, in-situ monitoring, and reliable geospatial information for sustainable development, policymaking, and project operations. And indeed, everything in our world has a spatial dimension. Poverty and other societal characteristics, economic trends, food security, changes to ecosystems, and aspects related to society well-being or inequality all hold physical dimensions. Ground and remote sensors measure and collect climatological and environmental data, such as the quality of water, air, and soil. Mobile phones and GPS devices collect data on movement of people. Cameras constantly monitor the functionality of critical infrastructure. Sensors on board satellites, airborne, and UAVs capture almost every location on Earth, monitoring economic activity and agricultural land productivity. Stream gauges help track the impacts of floods on vulnerable populations, while volunteer geographic information is collected and contributed by volunteers, complementing more traditional and official data sources. As will be demonstrated in the next 2 days, satellite data, for example, are being used today to measure the economic and societal impacts of COVID-19, including by looking at changes in nighttime light emissions. The use of such sources to track Earth is not new. More than 45 years of data collected by satellites and other devices is continuously being stored and can tell a compelling story about how Earth is changing, from urbanization processes, deforestation, food security, access to fresh water, sea level rise, global warming, and more. Machine learning techniques and AI are increasingly used to make sense of all this data and to automatically detect patterns of processes on Earth. Geospatial data is also continuing to play an important role in disaster management operations. This data is used to map and identify risks and hazards, estimate future exposure of vulnerable populations to climate change-related risks, help guide mitigation plans, and equip citizens with information necessary for their survival. In the last few years, we are seeing a change in the geospatial data industry and a trend towards making spatial data more accessible and freely available. Publicly available remotely sensed data collected, for example, by sensors on board Landsat or Sentinel satellites at a spatial resolution of up to 10 meters, is used to understand physical and socioeconomic dynamics in every location on Earth. Nighttime light data collected since the 1990s is leveraged to map poverty or to estimate the distribution of populations and economic activity. In parallel, cloud-based computational platforms and supercomputers are increasingly used for large-scale analysis and provide near real-time estimates on physical and social processes on Earth. Researchers are using advanced machine learning and AI methods to map many aspects of our world, like population counts, deforestation, land cover and land use, and flood models, and make these maps and products available for endless research applications. Importantly, with the increased availability of so much diverse data, new tools and methodologies are developed and made available and accessible to sectors who traditionally did not rely or knew how to make sense of geospatial data. In parallel, much effort is put towards capacity building and development of basic training on the use of geospatial data, applications, and tools to promote a more sustainable environment and society. In the next 2 days, you will hear about innovative use cases that leverage nighttime light data to measure development or impact. Tomorrow, you will learn some tools and techniques that can be used to translate nighttime light data into meaningful information also relevant to developing countries. The Geo4Dev website, which we will introduce shortly, will serve as a hub for geospatial data, tools, academic research, and training materials relevant to measuring many aspects related to developing countries. Finally, I want to encourage you all to submit a full paper or communication to two special issues in Remote Sensing Journal. The first one is on the use of remote sensing measurements to monitor the progress of countries towards achieving the SDGs. You can get more information on how to submit your paper to this special issue using this QR code. The second special issue is closely related to this symposium and workshop. We invite you to submit novel papers on the use of remote sensing nighttime light data in any scientific domain. You can use this QR code to get more information on how to submit your paper. We look forward to partnering with researchers, NGOs, and the private sector. But to make this happen, we will also need financial support to help us make Geo4Dev a central and accessible hub that bridges the gap between developing countries, sustainable development, and relevant geospatial solutions. Please reach out to us to learn more about how to become a partner or to support us. Thank you for your attention, and I will now hand it over to Gabe Levine, who will present the Geo4Dev website.